On a fine morning, when Bill was peacefully enjoying his walk around the park, he saw a kid holding a chocolate bar and experiencing some sort of heavenly joy as he chewed it. Bill, being curious, rushed to the store and tried Kinder Bueno for the first time. Every emotion in his head melted along with the bite of that chocolate bar. All he could think of was, with its crispy wafer, creamy hazelnut filling, and silky smooth chocolate coating, it's practically a work of art. But how does this marvel of modern confectionery come to life? Is it true that their chocolates undergo mineral oil contamination, or just some negative PR stunt? And did Bill really have to go to a store to buy one just to try it? I mean, me personally would have just taken it from the kid. Chocolates are bad for their health anyways. Spoiler alert, there's no chocolate wizard waving a wand. Nope, it's all about advanced technology, precise ingredients, and a lot of tender layering care. Stick around as we take you behind the scenes to uncover the step-by-step process that transforms raw ingredients into this chocolatey icon. Kinder Bueno, a global phenomenon. Before we go deeper into the factory process, let's zoom out for a moment. Did you know Kinder Bueno is sold in over 60 countries worldwide? Launched in 1990 in Italy, it quickly became a favorite snack across Europe and beyond. In fact, it's one of Ferrero's top-selling products, with over 2 billion bars sold annually. That's enough Kinder Buenos to circle the Earth nearly 15 times. Talk about a global chocolate takeover. Setting the stage, the ingredients. Let's start with the essentials. What's inside a Kinder Bueno? The first ingredient on our chocolatey checklist is hazelnuts. But not just any hazelnuts. Kinder Bueno's hazelnuts are high-quality nuts sourced from Turkey, where they're treated like royalty. These aren't your average grocery store nuts. They're roasted to perfection in giant industrial ovens until they reach that golden brown, nutty nirvana. Let's circle back to the star of the show, hazelnuts. Turkey produces nearly 70% of the world's hazelnuts, and Ferrero is one of the largest buyers. But it's not just about quantity. Ferrero invests in direct farming programs to support small-scale hazelnut farmers, ensuring quality and fair practices. And here's a nugget to blow your mind. Hazelnuts aren't just roasted. They go through laser sorting technology to remove any defective nuts. That's right, a laser scans every single hazelnut to ensure only the best make it into Kinder Bueno. If that's not hazelnut royalty treatment, what is? Then there's the milk chocolate. Ferrero, the parent company behind Kinder Bueno, has a super secret recipe that combines milk, cocoa butter, sugar, and a dash of cocoa liquor. It's crafted to melt in your mouth at just the right temperature, giving you that oh-so-smooth experience. And if that's not enough chocolate for you, Bueno also features a drizzle of dark chocolate on top for a bit of contrast. It's like adding a tuxedo to an already fancy outfit. Finally, we've got the wafer. Now, don't underestimate this crunchy component. The wafer is more than just a placeholder for the filling. It's a structural genius. Engineered to be ultra-thin yet sturdy, it creates the perfect snap when you bite into it. But why stop there? Each wafer has microscopic air pockets designed to absorb just the right amount of hazelnut cream without going soggy. It's practically a science experiment you can eat. Step 1. The Hazelnut Cream Odyssey. Our chocolate journey begins in the heart of the Kinder factory, where hazelnuts are transformed into a creamy dream. Imagine massive industrial blenders spinning roasted hazelnuts into a paste so smooth it could win an award for best texture. This isn't your run-of-the-mill hazelnut spread. It's enriched with sugar, cocoa butter, and other magical ingredients to create a filling that's equal parts creamy, nutty, and sweet. But how is the taste so perfectly stable and consistent? The consistency is no accident. Kinder's food scientists have nailed the exact balance to ensure the cream flows perfectly into the wafer layers, too thick, and the machine's jam, too runny, and the cream leaks. It's like Goldilocks got a PhD in food engineering. This cream is just right, but it's not all science and machines. Quality control plays a huge role here. Every batch of hazelnut cream is taste-tested by a team of chocolate experts. Yes, there are people whose full-time job is to eat hazelnut cream. I know what you're thinking. How do I sign up for this job? Step 2. Wafer Wanderland. Let's move on to the unsung hero of Kinder Bueno, the wafer. Making these crispy layers isn't as simple as you might think. It all starts with a carefully mixed batter made of flour, sugar, and a little magic. Well, maybe just some water and oil, but it feels like magic. The batter is poured onto long conveyor belts and spread super thin. How thin, you ask? So thin you could probably see through it if it wasn't for the baking process. These conveyor belts then slide into industrial ovens hotter than a midsummer day in the Sahara. The result? Perfectly baked wafer sheets with an audible crunch that's so satisfying it should have its own ASMR channel. Once cooled, the wafer sheets are cut into precise rectangles. But here's where the real wizardry begins: layering. Imagine a robot so precise it could assemble a house of cards in a windstorm. These machines stack the wafers and hazelnut cream layer by layer, creating that perfect balance of crispy and creamy. One layer of wafer, one layer of cream, another wafer, more cream. It's a symphony of textures. Ever wonder how Kinder Bueno's wafers stay so thin yet strong? The answer lies in their patented baking process. Each wafer is baked in custom molds that control thickness to within fractions of a millimeter. This ensures the perfect crunch every single time. And here's a detail you'll appreciate. The wafer batter isn't just basic. It includes special enzymes that enhance crispness and shelf life, meaning your Kinder Bueno will taste fresh, whether you buy it today or 6 months from now. And let's not forget, every wafer is inspected for flaws. If it's cracked, chipped, or even slightly uneven, it's rejected, because Kinder Bueno doesn't settle for meh. Step 3. Chocolate enrobing. The sweet spa day now. For the most indulgent step, the chocolate coating. The layered wafers travel down the conveyor belt straight into a chocolate waterfall. Yep, that's right. A literal curtain of melted milk chocolate cascades over the bars, covering them in a silky, chocolatey embrace. But here's the catch. The bottom of the bar is left uncoated. Why? It's all about practicality. The uncoated base ensures the bar doesn't stick to the wrapper, because let's face it, no one wants to wrestle with chocolate-covered foil when all you want is a snack. Let's talk chocolate science. Did you know the milk chocolate in Kinder Bueno is tempered? This means it's cooled and reheated in a specific temperature range to give it that glossy finish and satisfying snap. Tempering also ensures the chocolate melts at just the right moment, on your tongue, not in your hands. And while the dark chocolate drizzle looks decorative, it's not just for show. It adds a subtle bitterness to balance the sweetness of the milk chocolate and hazelnut cream. Think of it like adding a pinch of salt to caramel. It's all about balance. After the milk chocolate layer, it's time for the final flourish, the dark chocolate drizzle. A high-tech nozzle zigzags across the bars, creating that signature decorative pattern. It's like Kinder Bueno is putting on its Sunday best. Once the chocolate layers are complete, the bars head into a cooling tunnel, a long, refrigerated conveyor belt where the chocolate solidifies to perfection. Think of it as a spa day. But instead of massages, it's all about chilling out in chocolatey bliss. But what about the quality and taste? Is that one of Kinder Bueno's overlooked factors? Step 4. Quality control. Chocolate's toughest critics. You'd think the chocolate journey would end here, but nope. Every Kinder Bueno goes through rigorous quality checks. Machines scan the bars for imperfections, ensuring the wafers are properly layered, the chocolate coating is even, and the drizzle isn't out of place. If a single detail is off, the bar is rejected. And yes, humans also get involved in this process. A team of trained tasters, basically professional chocolate eaters, samples random bars from each batch to ensure they meet Kinder's exacting standards. If it passes, it's good to go. If not, it's back to the drawing board. And don't worry, rejected bars don't go to waste. They're recycled into other products or used for further testing. Step 5. Packaging and distribution. Finally, it's time for packaging. Kinder Bueno is wrapped in that iconic foil and orange wrapper, designed to lock in freshness and prevent the chocolate from melting before it reaches your hands. These wrappers are printed and sealed at lightning speed, hundreds of bars per minute. You've probably noticed that Kinder Bueno comes in individually wrapped twin bars. This isn't just for convenience, it's a strategic choice. Now let's talk about something serious: sustainability. Ferrero, the parent company, is committed to sourcing 100% sustainable cocoa by 2025. They're also working with hazelnut farmers to ensure ethical practices and reduce environmental impact. So when you're eating a Kinder Bueno, you're not just indulging, you're supporting a company that's trying to make a difference. Even the packaging is getting a green makeover. Ferrero has pledged to make all their wrappers recyclable or reusable in the near future. Chocolate with a conscience? Yes, please. And that's the deliciously complicated process behind Kinder Bueno. From premium hazelnuts to chocolate waterfalls, the next time you unwrap one, remember all the care and precision that went into making it. If this video made you hungry, hit the like and subscribe button. And don't forget to tell us in the comments, what's your favorite chocolate treat? Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a Kinder Bueno waiting for some serious research.